Hey, good morning, kids.
Good morning.
Welcome back. Welcome back on this beautiful Sunday morning. And it's time to do Children's Church once again.
Yeah,
all right. We have Georgette and
Hi.
Sally.
Hi.
And me, Ricky, over here.
Of course.
Yes, thank you. And we're going to go ahead and keep going through Psalm 91. We are almost at the end of this lesson, and we'll come up with other things to talk about later on. But I think right now, let's have the verse put up. Let's, Mr. Title Guy.
Mr. Title Man,
can you put it up? Psalm 91:15. That's great.
That's great.
Sally, can you read that? Can you tell?
Sure.
Yeah.
Psalm 91:15. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him.
Ooh, that's a good verse.
That's a really good verse. Yeah, it is.
You know, in troubled times, we shouldn't break our fellowship with God.
No, you shouldn't. You shouldn't. There are times when trouble comes. We all go through troubles and issues and stuff like that. And everyone on earth has troubles. Everyone. Every single person has troubles at some time. And during these times, Satan, you know, the devil, he wants us to believe that God has deserted us, that God's not there anymore, and that he doesn't care or love us anymore. But you've got to hold on to the Lord's promises during that time firmer than ever. You've got to believe that God loves you, and you've got to stay in the secret place of the Most High.
Mm-hmm.
Keep a sweet spirit, and the Lord will bring you out of that difficulty with his almighty loving hand.
Ooh, that's good.
Yeah.
See, everyone on earth has troubles from time to time.
Yeah.
Jesus actually said, in the world you shall have tribulation. That's a big word.
That is a big word.
It just means troubles.
Troubles, yeah.
But be of good cheer. I, that being Jesus, have overcome the world.
Oh, that's wonderful. And we're also told in the Bible that the devil goes around like a roaring lion.
Oh, no.
He's seeking whomever he may devour. Does that mean he's actually going to eat you? No. That means he is waiting and looking for people he can convince to go against God.
Many are the afflictions. It's another big word.
It
also just means kind of like troubles.
Troubles.
Of the right. There are many afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord will deliver him out of all of them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, absolutely. He delivers us out of all of it. The devil wants us to think that we're all alone and that we are the only one that has ever faced this problem before or had this trial or trouble before. He wants us to think God does not care.
You know, that reminds me of a story of Joseph. He experienced a lot of troubles before he was made the governor of the land.
Oh, yeah. Like his brothers hated him,
mm-hmm.
and they couldn't speak nicely or kindly to him because, you know, he's the favorite of his father. And then, he also got that coat. His father gave him that special coat. And his brothers sold him as a slave when he was 17 years old. Can you imagine being sold as a slave? I know sometimes you think you're a slave because, you know, mom asks you to clean your room or something. But no, this is different. He was sold as a slave when he was 17, and he was taken to be a slave in Egypt and a guy named Potiphar's house.
Aww.
And in spite of all of this, Joseph stayed in love with God. He did not become bitter.
When he was in Potiphar's house, he became boss over all of the slaves.
Then
he was wrongly accused of attacking Potiphar's wife.
That was terrible.
He was thrown in prison because of that.
And still, Joseph stayed in love with God. He did not become bitter.
He did not. Joseph became the boss over all the prisoners, and Joseph gave the interpretation of the baker and the cupbearer's dreams. Remember that, you know? And the cupbearer promised to speak to the king to get Joseph out of prison after he got thrown into jail because Potiphar's wife accused him of things. But the cupbearer forgot about Joseph for 2 more years.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it was a long time.
And even in those 2 years, Joseph stayed in love with God. He did not become bitter.
Finally, the cupbearer did remember him, and Joseph was called to interpret Pharaoh's dream.
Yeah.
Joseph became the boss over all of the land of Egypt.
Yeah, and he was like 30 years old when he did this.
Mm-hmm. So when trouble comes, you should hold on to God's word.
You remind yourself of God and who he is.
and who you are in Christ. And remind yourself who God is. Remind yourself who you are in Christ.
Mm-hmm.
You are His child. You are a Christian. You have a covenant, an agreement with God.
Oh, that's a big word.
That's a big word, yeah.
So you can study the Word of God, yeah. And God will speak to you through His Word.
Yes, He will.
Also, pray, because God speaks to us by the Holy Spirit.
That is right. That's right. Believe in the promises of God. Stand in faith. Don't waver. That means don't start to not believe. Commit your way to the Lord and rest in Him.
Mm-hmm.
He is your fortress.
It reminds me of a verse. In all your ways, acknowledge Him, and He will direct your path. He will show you where to go.
I know that one. That's a great one. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, I think it's time for a song.
Ooh,
so
what
let's
song?
I don't know. Mr. Title Man!
Mr. Title Man!
Oh, all right, good.
Oh,
yeah,
good
His
one.
Banner Over Me is Love. That's a good song. All right, so we'll sing it together, and you kids follow along at home, and we'll start at the count of three. One, two, three.
Jesus is the rock of my salvation, His banner over me is love. Jesus is the rock of my salvation, His banner over me is love. Jesus is the rock of my salvation, His banner over me is love. His banner over me is love. Jesus is the vine and we are the branches, His banner over me is love. Jesus is the vine and we are the branches, His banner over me is love. Jesus is the vine and we are the branches, His banner over me is love. His banner over me is love.
Good job, good job.
Good job.
That was great.
Job,
that was great. All right. Well, I think maybe it's time for a skit.
Ooh, I love
skits. Yeah.
Skits
are fun.
Are great.
Skits are fun sometimes. So we'll go get ready for the skit, and you guys stay right there. And Mr. Title Guy, will you put up the name of the skit, please?
Mr.
Title Man, please.
Kingdom of Judah, there lived a king named Hezekiah. That's me. Hello there, loyal subjects. I love God. Do you love the Lord? One day I was minding my own business when some very nasty messengers came to deliver a message for me from their very nasty king.
Yes, yes, I'm a nasty messenger. Yes, yes. I'm a very nasty guy, and I work for a very nasty king. That's right. And whenever my king wants to take over somebody else's country, he sends me to go there to first scare the living daylights out of people. Are you scared yet?
No.
Well, you will be. Are your royal subjects scared yet? Well, you will be. You all will be. You'll all be afraid.
I'm trusting in the Lord.
You're trusting in the Lord? God can't save you. The king I work for is stronger than any god. He has taken over lots of country, and now he's coming to take over yours.
Let's not talk in this language. Let's talk in the language from your country, so you don't scare my loyal subjects.
No, I want your loyal subjects to understand what we're talking about. If you don't surrender to my king, then you are going to starve to death.
If you do surrender, then we'll capture you and take you away to my country.
You want to make us into slaves?
Now are you scared? Now are you scared? I have something for you, Mr. King. Here's a letter for you. This is a letter from my king. He is coming, and he's going to take over all this place. You'll be sorry, and you'll be sorry, and God can't help you. So don't trust in him.
Well, I did the best thing I could at a time like this. I took that letter, and I went to pray. I opened the letter, and I showed it to God. And then I prayed, Lord, you are God who made heaven and earth. Listen to what this nasty king is saying about you. Please save us. Then God sent a prophet to me with a message saying, you are going to laugh at the enemy, said God. I will save this city. The bad king will not come into this city.
Yes, yes, I'm back. And this time I brought the whole army with me, and we are going to attack you. Well, but first, I'm tired. I'm going to take a little nap. Is that okay? You watch over me, Mr. Army Person, and I will sleep right here.
Well, that night, an angel of the Lord went to the nasty army's camp and killed all 180,000 of the soldiers. The nasty king went home to his country after that. Hey, what's happening? Hey, he's dead! The wicked Rabakishek is dead! His whole army is dead! Hooray for God! He saved us! He saved us! No need to see that. Royal subjects, I love the Lord. Do you love the Lord? Royal subjects, trust in the Lord with your whole long life, okay?
Ah, that was a good skit. Good skit all about King Hezekiah and that bad guy Rabshakeh coming. Ooh. Oh, that was.
He had a nice cape.
He did. It was a nice cape, even though he was a nasty guy. But that story you can find in 2 Kings 18 and 19. That's where that comes from. All right. Well, I think it's time
for a song.
For a song! Yay! So we need to know what song.
Yes.
So
we have to ask. The Mr. Title Man.
Mr. Title Man!
Mr. Title Man!
Mr. Title Man!
Hello! Oh, we haven't done this one in a while in Jones Church.
Mm-hmm.
He's got the whole world in his hands.
It's a good song.
That's a good song. It's a great reminder that God is in control and he knows everything going on and he has it all under control.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so kids, hopefully you remember this. If not, get your parents to help you because they know it. Parents, you know the song. And you can
you
sing
can
along.
Sing with us.
You can sing with us, okay? Again, on the count of three, he's got the whole world in his hands. One, two, three.
He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the itty-bitty babies. In his hands, he's got the itty-bitty babies. In his hands, he's got the itty-bitty babies. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the wind and the rain. In his hands, he's got the wind and the rain. In his hands, he's got the wind and the rain. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands. he's got everybody here. In his hands, he's got everybody here. In his hands, he's got everybody here. In his hands, he's got the whole world in his hands.
Good job, good job.
Nice job, guys, good job.
All right, I think what we're going to do is we're going to have another skit. And I have another special guest today,
so
who's going to help me with a skit. So we'll go and get ready for that, and we'll see you right back. Mr. Title Guy, can you put up the skit? Mr. Title Man? Hello?
What are you doing, Ricky? What?
I said, hello there, Miss Jessie. I was singing a song about Abraham. I dropped my pen.
Okay, but I can't understand you when you have something in your mouth. So, What do you even have in your mouth? What?
I said it's my new phantasmagorical pen. I love it so much, and I don't want to lose it. Oh, I dropped it again. I gotta get it.
Well, why not just hold it in your hands, and so that way you can sing with your mouth? I still can't understand you, Ricky.
I said, because I have these little puppet hands, so I can't really hold the pen, so the best way it works is for me to hold it in my mouth. Now I gotta go get it again.
Well, I mean, your mouth works quite enough to make up for not being able to use your arms. I'll just hold it for you. There you go.
No! My pen! My new pen! My new pen! She took it! She took my new pen!
Okay. Oh. I'll give it back.
Oh, good.
Goodness, Ricky, you need to have more trust.
Rust? How could I rust? Only things made of metal can rust. Like old cars and tractors or hammers and screwdrivers that farmers leave out in the rain. I can't rust.
No,
that's just a silly
Ricky,
thing to say.
Not rust.
Talking about rust,
you need to have more trust.
What? Crust? Why would I need crust? They make my fur all curly. No self-respecting puppet wants curly hair. I'd look like this. Hold on, wait. I look like this. Come on, I look worse than Joe Bouchock. Look at that. No, I wouldn't want that. Who
Ricky,
would want to eat crust?
I said trust. Trust.
What? I don't want to be trust. No, I saw them do that at a rodeo once where they tied up this poor cow and they said it had been trussed up like a turkey. No, thank you. Puppets don't like to be tied up. It reminds me of the Dark Ages before Sesame Street when puppets were discriminated against. Back then, anyone with hairy ears or pointed teeth or looked like a rat or someone was holding on their hand got tied up and done away with. Come to think of it, half of those people out there would be in big trouble as well. All those people. Yeah. No, nobody would like it. No trussing me up. No way. Thank you.
No, sometimes you're so silly, Ricky.
What?
I mean trust. T-R-U-S-T.
Trust? What's that?
Trust is when you're confident that someone is honest. Like me, or when you depend on someone to keep their word or believe that they'll do what they say. When you have faith in someone.
Oh, well, why didn't you say so right at the beginning? We could have saved a lot of time, Miss Jessie. I know someone who trusted. Abraham trusted God. God said to Abraham that he had to move his house and family and go live in another country, but he didn't know what country. He didn't tell him what country. And even though he was old, he believed God when God said he would give him children. So Abraham trusted God. But how do I know I can trust you?
Ricky, have I ever lied to you?
Well, no.
Do I keep my promises unless something makes it impossible?
I suppose so.
Is there anything that would stop me from giving you your pen back? And keeping my word that I'll keep it safe?
Well, I guess only an earthquake or a twister or a flash flood or maybe alien invasion I suppose I can trust you.
Thanks,
all right,
Ricky.
You can hang on to my pen.
I won't let you down.
Okay, thank you. Hey, you know what? God didn't let Abraham down either. I guess that's how Abraham knew he could trust God. God keeps his promises. And nothing stops God from doing what he wants. That's what my song was about that I was singing earlier.
About trusting God?
Yep. We know we can trust God because he keeps his promises. We all should trust God and do whatever he says. God keeps his promises and we should trust him. He is our God.
Well, that sounds like a really good song. Why don't you sing a song about trusting God with the kids?
Oh, yeah, okay, we can do that. Will you help me with that, Miss Jessie?
I sure will.
All right, well, we got to ask Mr. Title Guy to give us a song. So, Mr. Title Guy, he's a guy who puts up words for us. So, you just do you trust me?
Yeah.
Do you trust me?
Yes.
All right, then trust me in this. Mr. Title Guy! Mr. Title Guy! Ah, there we go. Trust and obey. That's a good song about trusting God and obeying him. Miss Jessie, you don't mind staying and helping us sing this?
Oh, not at all.
Ah, gee, that's swell. We like having humans around here. And why don't I get Georgette and Sally back up here, too? Georgette, Sally, there we are. Everyone's
here.
There
we
are. We got Miss Jessie. There we go. Perfect. So we will sing Trust and Obey. We'll count to three and then sing. You sing along at home. And ready? One, two, three.
When we walk with the Lord in the light of his word, what a glory he sheds on the way. While we do his good will, he abides with us still, and with all who will trust and obey. Trust and obey. For there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Not a shadow can rise, not a cloud in the skies, but his smile quickly drives it away. Not a doubt nor a fear, not a sigh nor a tear can abide while we trust and obey. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey.
Good job! That was great! Yeah. Miss Jessie, you did a great job.
Oh,
and we were
you,
so happy to have you here to help us with that skit and to talk about trusting God and to lead us in this song. But I think now it's time for Pastor Jeff to come and talk. And we will see you guys next week for more songs and skits and maybe, maybe more guest speakers,
ooh,
guest stars. We can do that. So so we'll say goodbye for right now, and we will see you guys next week.
Bye!
Bye, girls.
Goodbye,
Miss Jessie. Goodbye, Ricky.
Goodbye, Miss Jessie.
Hey kids, welcome back to another Sunday for Children's Church. I hope everyone's having a great Sunday. I hope you are paying attention to Ricky and the girls and listening through the lesson that they're teaching us through Psalm 91. It's such a great psalm with so much in it, talking about what a mighty fortress God is for us, what a mighty protector God is. Psalm 91:15 says, "He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him." Well, as you heard Ricky and the girls talk about earlier, in troubled times, we need to make sure we turn to God, that we cry out to God, that we don't break our fellowship with God. And there are times when trouble is going to come, right? We're always going to have trials or tribulations or issues or problems or troubles. I mean, we're still in the pandemic, right? We're still not able to go to church with each other. We have to stay home. We can't go and visit the people we want to go see or go out to movies or restaurants or playgrounds. But that time will pass. This will pass. God has us under control. And everyone on earth is having the same problem, right? They're having the same trial, the same issue that we're having. And during these times, Satan really wants us to believe God's deserted us, that he's not there to help us. But we know that he is. He's here to protect us, and he'll bring us out of difficulty with his
loving hand if we just turn to him and trust him. And I want to share a story with you today. It's a small little short story, and it's a sad story. I'm sorry. It's sad. It's about a chicken. And I know you're laughing now. It's like, okay, it's about a chicken, but it's sad. Because this chicken was a mother hen, and where she lived, there was a horrible fire. And after the fire was all put out, somebody found this mother hen, and her body was all charred black from the fire, all burnt up. And the person only found the burnt up chicken because he heard peeping sounds coming from that area. So when he walked over there and saw this burnt chicken and he moved it aside, all these baby chicks ran out in every direction. All these babies, and they were fine. There was nothing wrong with them. But the mother hen, she had given her life to protect all these baby chicks during the time of a devastating fire. We read a few weeks ago in Psalm 91, in verse 4, that it says, "He shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you shall take refuge." Well, so that means, just like that chicken in my story, that's how it is with God's love. He loves us so much that he wants us to be gathered under his wings so that he can protect us from the evil that's around us today. And there is evil all around us today, kids. Whether we see it right away or not, it's there. So maybe that chicken story didn't quite do it for you. So maybe to explain it a bit better to you, I can use an object lesson, a visual, right? So I have this. Do we know what this is? That's right, that's an umbrella, right? So I want you to watch what happens when I do this and I open it up. It's a pretty big umbrella, right? Now I want you to pretend that we're in trouble and this umbrella represents God's protection for us. So let's say we're in trouble and this is God's protection. We can get right under this and we can tuck under the shadow of his wings, right? I can get protected. I'm still here. I'm just under the protection of the umbrella, right? Whenever we want to be protected, and that should be all the time, we need only to remember to pray and ask God to protect us. Because the Bible has God's words recorded for us, and we can be assured that even in scary situations, God will protect us. Just as that mother hen spread her wings to protect her baby chicks, we can trust God to protect us. Another passage that talks about this is in Psalm 17, verse 8, where it says, "Keep me as the apple of your eye and hide me under the shadow of your wings." When we find peace as we pray, we can move about knowing that God is always with us, always protecting us like this umbrella. One of God's wonderful promises to us in the Bible is found in Hebrews 13, verse 5, where it says, "For he himself has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you." Let me show you another way that this umbrella explains God's protection. Why do we use umbrellas? Why would we use this thing? That's right, to keep the rain off us. When the rain falls, we have a choice to either get under an umbrella like this or walk in the rain instead. And if we choose to walk in the rain, what will happen? That's right, we're going to get wet. We're going to get wet, but if we stay under the umbrella, the rain won't soak us. Well, that's how it is with God's protection. God allows us to make our own choices. He does. Just like the umbrella, we can choose to use the umbrella or not. If we choose God's ways, we're protected. But if we choose not to obey God or make decisions that don't please God, it's like we want to walk in the rain unprotected. We're going to get soaking wet. So if we make unwise choices, we're unprotected, and we're going to get wet. Right? Wet. When we realize that our decision was not pleasing to God, we should run back under his umbrella as quickly as possible and ask forgiveness. And then we'll begin to dry off and soon be walking with God again, protected from the storms of life. I know I'm using all rainy weather related terms because I had an umbrella, that's why I'm using that, but I could use chicken terms if you want. When something big and scary is coming to eat a baby chick, they run back under the protection of their mother hen wings to protection. Don't you think this is a much better idea to walk with God and do things His way rather than doing it our own way? I hope that the next time it rains, and by that I mean the next time troubles come in your life or storms come into your life, or the next time you have a decision to make, that you will think about what you've learned today from Ricky and the girls and this little lesson here from me about God's love and protection for us. We as Christians, we have a God who loves us and wants to protect us and is there for us. All we have to do is ask. Remember to pray and ask God to protect you from whatever it is you're fearful of. And if you're watching this today and you're saying, well, I'm not a Christian. I'm just someone who clicked on a button to watch this because I like Ricky the Rat. I like him too. I mean, he messes up my office, but I like him. Well, if you're someone who doesn't call themselves a Christian because you haven't accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior, well, maybe now's the time to do that. Maybe you're feeling the pressure from everything on the outside world and you're saying, I'm so nervous and afraid and anxious about everything going on. Am I ever going to go back to school? Am I ever going to be allowed to go back to a store without wearing a mask? Can I ever go to the playground again? Well, maybe now's the time to look to God and say, God, I want you to be my protector too. But how do I do that? Well, all you have to do is put your faith in Jesus Christ. You see, God created us to be with Him forever. But then sin came into the world. And He didn't plan for that necessarily, but that's the way it happened. But He knew it was going to happen. So He came up with a plan to get us back into the fold, so to speak, to get us back under the protection of His wings. He sent Jesus Christ here to earth nearly 2,000 years ago, a little bit over 2,000 years ago, to teach us and then to die on the cross and take our sins on Himself so we wouldn't have to. And that might be very hard for you to understand. And I guess the best way I can put it is this way. Let's say you do something wrong. And if you're really honest with yourself, we all do things that are wrong, right? We all do things that are bad. And God can't have that near Him because God's pure. He's perfect. And that's why He sent Jesus. But let's say you did something bad, really bad, right? And you go to court, right? The police arrest you and you go in front of a judge. And that judge, if he's a good judge and you actually did something wrong, he's going to say, well, I'm sorry, you did something wrong. So you need to go to jail. You need to be punished. No one would ever want that to happen to them, right? So let's say in that moment, the judge says, I'm sorry, you need to be punished. You did this thing wrong. And you're like, yes, I did. I admit it. I did this thing wrong. But what if somebody all of a sudden stepped in and said, whoa, 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 wait a minute. Mr. Judge, I know you're about to send this person to his punishment, but I know this person and I love them. So I want to go in their place. That'd be a pretty good friend, wouldn't it? Well, that's exactly what Jesus did 2,000 years ago, a little over 2,000 years ago. He went before God and he said, whoa, whoa, wait. I taught these people about you and they're my family and I love them. Let me take the punishment for their sin. So that's what Jesus did on the cross. He paid the penalty for our sins so we wouldn't have to. All the sins we already committed and all the sins we will ever commit. And all we have to do to be a Christian, to be with God forever someday, is just say, I believe in you, God. I believe that you sent Jesus to die for my sins because I am someone who does things that are bad, who does wrong things. And I want you to be my God. I want you to be my Savior. So please accept me as one of your children. That's all it takes. There's no special prayer. There's no special ritual or you don't have to wear anything special or anything like that. It's just placing your faith in Jesus Christ, that He is the person that paid the price for your sin, that He's that guy that said, hey, wait, I love that person. let me go in his place or her place. That's all it takes. So I want you to think about that if you've never done that before. Maybe do that today. And if you're still not sure and you have questions, my phone number is 603-595-0955. Comes right here into the church. Leave a message for me. I will call you back. And we can talk about it. And I know it's hard to get together. We can do a Zoom call or Skype or on the phone or by email. If you have any questions, just reach out to me. My email is right on the website here. You can talk to any one of us pastors or any of the Sunday school teachers. We'd be happy to talk to you about it. And if you do make this decision today, then welcome to the family of God. And if you're already a Christian, pray for someone like this. Talk to your family and friends about who God is and who Jesus is and what Jesus did for them. But most of all, remember the lesson from today, that God will protect you, but you just need to call out to him. It's much the same as if you needed help from the fire department or the police department or an ambulance. How do you get their attention? How do you get them to come help you? That's right. You pick up the phone, you dial 911. You've got to call them, right? They won't just know that your house is on fire or know that there's been an accident. Someone has to call them. Now, God knows everything, but he wants to hear from you still. And while he does know what's going on in your life, he would like you to call upon him, and he will protect you. Well, it's wonderful to be able to come and share with you guys. I really can't wait till we do this again in person. I miss seeing all your faces. I don't even think I can remember everybody's names off the top of my head, but I miss Savannah, and I miss, oh my goodness, Perrin and Fiona, and I miss all you Wilkins kids. Riley, Lucy, Weston, Hollis, Millie. I'm sure I'm missing somebody there. There's so many of you. I miss seeing all you kids in Children's Church. I miss seeing Gabriel. I know Mrs. Grant, myself, and Miss Jillian, and Miss Jessie, and Miss Anna, Miss Kira. I know we all miss seeing you guys, and we can't wait to get back together. But we can trust that God is in control of all this, and he has this for us, meaning he's got it all figured out. It may take a little bit more time, but that's okay. Trust God. Pray to God. Ask him to help you be strong in all of this. I do that every day. You know me, I love people. I don't like talking to a computer. I want to talk to you. But we'll do that again soon. This isn't forever. It's just a little time. And I know it seems like it's a very long time because it's been so many weeks so far. But really, in the grand scheme of eternity, this is just a little blip on the radar. Not long at all. We'll see each other again soon enough. Well, you guys go out and enjoy the beautiful day. Remember to love your parents. Parents, you love your children back. Talk about what God has done for you and call out to him for his protection. We love you. We miss you. And we'll see you again, hopefully soon. Have a great day. Bye-bye. You know what? I know I already said goodbye to you and I was ready to move on, but I realized I haven't prayed with you guys yet today. And I didn't want to end the day or end the video without praying with you. So we're going to take a moment right now. We're going to pray to God and thank him for his protection. We're going to thank him for being there so we can trust in him. And again, if you haven't trusted in Christ as your Savior, now's a good time to do that. So let's go ahead and pray. Heavenly Father, we are so thankful that you are there for us, that you provide protection for us, just like that mother hen, just like that umbrella, that you cover us with your love, with your mercy, and protect us from the evils in this world. Lord, I pray for all the children and all the families that are watching this right now, Lord, that they call out to you when they feel that they're being pressured or they feel like they're going through troubles or trials, Lord, and that you protect them. And if there be someone here today who hasn't accepted you as their savior yet, Lord. I ask that you touch their heart today. Bring them to the point of realization that, yes, I am someone who does things bad, wrong, sin, and that I need someone to save me from this. And Jesus, I want you to be that savior. I believe that you came here to earth and you died for my sins, and then you rose from the dead on the third day, Lord. Please be my savior. I pray, Lord, that there is someone today that has made that prayer. They've put their faith in you. And while we all understand the prayer does not save them, it is the faith, Lord, we pray that you work in their hearts. And for those of us that are your children, just keep strengthening us, allowing us to turn to you, to lean on you, and rely on you for everything. And we ask this in your precious name, Lord Jesus. Amen. All right. I didn't want a Sunday to end without praying with you children and with your families. I hope everyone enjoys this beautiful day. Like I said before, go and just spend time together knowing that God has you protected. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.